Greetings, everybody. This is Dr. Jonathan Cox here with your weekly lecture. This week, we are focusing on jokes, specifically racialized and racist jokes, as well as political correctness. Your weekly readings look at political correctness through social media in more detail, so we'll look more closely at jokes in this lecture. In general, we can think of racist jokes as jokes that rely on racial stereotypes, particularly those stereotypes that position non-whites as counter to and different from whites, as well as jokes that seek to convey messages of inferiority for racial and ethnic minorities. There is much debate about racist jokes and racist humor, including whether or not they are actually racist and thus reinforce racism more broadly, as well as discussion about the intent of these jokes versus their impact, not only on racial and ethnic minorities, but also on the perceptions and beliefs of whites. One scholar, sociologist Raul Perez of the University of Denver in Colorado, studies racial humor, and through his research, he has drawn connections between racist humor and pervasive racist ideologies, in particular, colorblindness, which we know is the dominant racial ideology post-civil rights in the United States. Perez contends that racist humor has long been utilized in the United States as a way to foster social cohesion among whites as the dominant group at the expense of racial and ethnic minorities, which works to reinforce everyday systemic forms of white supremacy through what Joe Fagan, another sociologist, calls the white racial frame. In other words, jokes that target racial and ethnic minorities as others who are stupid, dangerous, inferior, or other negative tropes can produce and reproduce ethnocentric worldviews and perpetuate limiting and negative beliefs about non-whites as compared to whites. A good example can be seen in historical images of black minstrelsy that continue to resurface in contemporary times. Perez suggests that because we are now in a society where talking about race, particularly in explicit racist terms, is considered taboo, people are more likely to engage in what he calls the forbidden fruits of racism by using fun and humor to offset their racist expressions. Through the use of colorblind framing, people can make jokes about racial and ethnic minorities that reinforce negative beliefs and racist ideologies, all while claiming these jokes are harmless or all in good fun. Social media and the internet more broadly have become major ways that racist jokes and humor can be shared widely and often without direct consequence because of features like anonymity. For instance, scholar Michael Billig noted that racist jokes were being circulated on the internet from its early years of inception through far-right and white supremacist websites. Now, these sites were full of jokes that dehumanize and make fun of blacks using violent, racist humor. Yet, as Perez suggests, these websites frequently frame their jokes as both harmless humor and fun, and not as overt racism, which is a classic formulation of colorblind ideology, which we all now know. Far-right and white supremacist websites are not the only social media and online spaces where racist jokes can be found, however, and to assume so would be a big mistake. However, it's important to note that while racist jokes are not the sole purview of white supremacists, there is a lot of overlap between the types of jokes told by these overtly racist groups and the ones that are told on other websites, and that demonstrates the significance of the racial ideology that undergirds these racial jokes. But what are the impacts of racist humor and racist jokes? As I've already mentioned, a major impact is the reproduction of racist ideology that sees racial and ethnic minorities as inherently different from and inferior to whites, or white supremacy. Researcher Thomas Ford, a social psychologist, also suggests that racist humor, as a form of disparagement humor, or humor that is meant to amuse others by denigrating certain groups of people, can foster hatred and discrimination against targeted groups. For instance, by claiming that it's just a joke, people can subvert social norms and say things that are otherwise socially unacceptable. In the case of racist jokes, this means openly expressing prejudice. Further, because racist jokes are cast off as harmless, they can trivialize the lived experiences of historically marginalized and oppressed minority groups. Ford also notes, along with other scholars, that racialized humor can be used to subvert prejudice and call attention to negative racial stereotypes or systemic racism. But this can be very difficult. In order for this to work, the audience needs to recognize and appreciate the intention, and there's never any guarantee that this is going to occur. Additionally, research suggests that the level of prejudice in the individual consuming the joke matters. Those with high levels of prejudice are far less likely to correctly interpret subversive humor than those who have low levels of prejudice. All right, there it is, a brief, in-depth look at racist jokes and racial humor. Now, as you are completing the readings and assignments for this week, be sure to think about how you see racialized and racist jokes in social media spaces around you. Pay close attention to the way that people are framing these and contextualizing these jokes. I hope that now you have a much fuller understanding of the various impacts of racial jokes as well. That's it for today's lecture. Have a great day and peace.